Hello there, learners. So now today we are gonna do the same thing that we did previously, but this time with the database, so that when we close our application and rerun it, the data should be there so that we don't lose our database. Previously, what we were doing is we were doing the same thing, creating a crude application, REST API, but without a database. So with the benefit of that particular program was that we learned how can we do a crude application, how can we run it, what are the functionalities of a crude application, how does it behave and all that. But the drawback was when we closed the application and we were running it again, we were unable to see our data, the data that we stored previously. Why? Because we were not using a database. There was no persistence of the data. So we were not storing it for like a long time. We were just using objects, and when the application was closed, the objects were destroyed and then nothing was there. So we are gonna change the previous application, and then based on that we are going to create an other application. Actually, it would be same application, but this time it would be using the database. So for the database, we have to decide which database that we want to use. So the topics today would be choosing a database, in which we'll go through which database to choose. It's up to you, but this time we are going to use a MongoDB. And how do we install it? We'll go through that. How do we create a bean for a database, especially for the MongoDB? How do we create a repository for the MongoDB, which would have different functionalities like find by ID, find by name, and all that? Then we'll do the same thing that we did with the previous ones. We'll create a repository. After that, we'll create a REST controller. Then we are going to create methods with the mappings, and then we'll just verify the API. So I hope everyone is ready. And let's go dig deep into the code. Choosing a database. So when we are going to choose a database, it's up to us which one do we want to choose. But the most preferable and most usable with the Spring Boot is nowadays MongoDB. Everybody tends to use MongoDB. Why? It's easier to use. It's NoSQL based, so document based. So gone are the days to use table-based or MySQL-based, SQL-based databases. So everybody is now moving to NoSQL-based, and MongoDB is like available so easily, and everybody can use it and download it, and then it's free. So yeah, I'm gonna choose the MongoDB, and we are going to create an application with the MongoDB. Now, how do we install the MongoDB? So to install the MongoDB, what we can do is like we can go to MongoDB site. We just go there. We download whichever we want. So we download the community server. So just download it based on the version that you need and all that. And afterwards install it. Once you have installed it, when you run it, it will be running its local port. So when you run it will be running on this one. So its port is default port is 27017. When you run it after installation and all that, it should give this one, this line. If it gives this line, this means the database is running. Now that we have installed the database and the database is running and all that, we are going to create our application so that it uses the MongoDB. Now let's go through the application. Now, so before we go, let's go to the previous, before we begin everything with the database, let's go to the previous code and see what was happening. Try to understand that, try to recap that, and then once we have recapped it, we'll actually do the same with the database. So there are a few changes that I have done. So to save the time, I've already done that. So let's go and do the previous and go through the previous code and all that. So previously the our application was the same. So we were running this application. So this is the same application, hello world application. This was the bean that we created. So without database, we don't need anything. But when we are going to use the database, we need a field for the ID. So I'll create an ID. So this is the same thing. So we have a field for the ID, it's setter scatters. So you, as you can see that here at this particular place, I'm using document collection student, which tells MongoDB, this particular thing tells MongoDB that the table that we are going to use is a student. Okay, so for this particular component, for this particular bean, the table that we will be using is named as a student. Okay, so or what you can say is like this particular document is going to be saved as a student in the database. So this document would be a student in the database for now, test it. So now let's go to CRUD controller. So we had a REST controller and then we were using our repositories and DAOs that we created manually. Now what we do here is like we create the same controller for a MongoDB. So everything is same. We have a student MongoDB repository, this object. So here we had our DAO implementation, here we have a repository object. So let's go to the repository object. Here we have nothing but an interface that extends the MongoDB repository. After extended it, we are giving some methods. Those are already not there in the, so we are going to just define our methods and MongoDB would take care of the implementation. So it will do the implementation for us. So what did we do is like we defined our find by ID, we defined our find by first name, we defined our find by age, and then we defined find by email. So what would happen is like MongoDB would create these methods inside it, so in a MongoDB repository, and then provide us the implementation out of the box so that we don't have to implement these methods for ourselves. So it will be done out of the box. There is nothing that we have to do, no queries and nothing. Everything would be done out of the box. So we go there, and now we have, so to differentiate between previous application and this application, what we have done is like the mappings for the methods is with DB, all the same, except in the end we have a DB. You can go and check, they don't have a DB, but this one has a DB in the end. So we have add record, we have get records, we have get record by ID, we have get update record, we have removed record by ID, then we have delete records from DB. The same functionality, but this time within a database. So what we are doing is like we take our student object, we get our repository object, which is this one, and then we save. This save method is already defined in the MongoDB repository. We are just using it. Since we are extending this particular interface, we can use all the objects of the MongoDB repository. Those are, so this MongoDB repository is actually a student MongoDB repository object. So now we use save. What we do is like we just give object save, and then it will save it inside the table. Which table do we use and how that would we'll be defining, and how are we going to connect the application in the MongoDB, that we go in the end. And now here we do is like we just say find all. So there are methods already defined in the repository, we just call them. So what it will do is like it will give us the list of student DB objects. So this student DB object is nothing, it's the same student, but I use it with the DB in the end to differentiate that there is an application without DB, there is an application with DB. Now it's the same. So here we are providing the ID, so it goes and finds the ID. It does here the same, deletes by the ID, now it updates, and then there here it is the delete all of them. So now what is happening is like we are getting all the records from the repository. So these methods are already defined, we just have to use them. now when we now what we do is like we actually go and see how are we making this connection possible. So we go and define in the application dot properties the properties, three properties. One of them is host, one of them is the name of the database, which is a student, and one of the so this name is what the database would be created into the MongoDB. The table would be created and everything named a student, and then we'll be using it for the data storage. Now here, this particular port is the port that we have to define where the MongoDB is running, and this is the host. So right now our MongoDB is running on a local host. So we run it. Now everything is fine. And let's check the application. So what we are gonna do is like we are gonna check the application by running it. First, what we are gonna do is like we are gonna check it without a data, without database. So we'll check it with the previous functionality, and then we'll close the application. We'll see the results. Then we'll check it with the database. We'll close the application. We'll see the results. So we'll see what actually. Oh, okay. One more thing. So once you are done with all of these would not work until unless we have this particular dependency in the POM. So we have to insert this dependency in the POM, which says our project that you have to use dependencies or jars for the MongoDB separately. So this would download all the necessary DBs or the necessary library files for the MongoDB to be used by our program. Don't forget it. I'm sorry that I remembered it in the last, but this is, I would say, the most important part. Without it, you can't do anything. Now let's go and check our application. So this is the same thing, but right now this is without database. So and this is with database. So we do without database. So we add a pro. So we have added a record in the database in the application, but without a database. Now there is a record in the database, but it does not have any in persistence. There is a record in the database, but it is not stored. So we like, I'm sorry, not in the database, but in the application. So here we are going to use another record, mark. John @gmail.com. We store another. So and we check. We have two records in there. Now, just excuse me. I'm sorry for that. So now we go back, close the application, rerun it, and then we check whether we have our records already in there or not. So we close our application. Application is not running. We go back to the application. And then we check whether our application has the same records that those we added or not. So we have to check them, and for that we rerun the application, and the application is running. So now we go and check. We don't have any records. Why? Because we did not save them in database. They were being done without database. Now what we do is like we go and do the same for the database. So here it is, our add record for the database functionality. So we add the record in database, we add another record in database, name it foo, and we name it bar, and we make it 29, and then we say foo bar at 29 or something like that. So another object was stored, so another record was stored. Now when we get records, So we have four records in the database. I actually saved previous ones, so there were like few previously. So let's delete all of them first, and then we do it the same. So from the beginning. So I do this one. So we go there, and then we take the and so we take this particular mapping. We use it here, and then we do this. So now when we go and get the records, there is no record already there. So now we know that it is empty, database is empty. So a record was saved, then we say foo1 bar 1. So another record was saved. Now we say foo2 bar 2. Another record was saved. Now how many records do we have? We have three records. Very good. Now we close the application and we'll check whether our records are still there or not. So what we are gonna do is like we are gonna close the application. So now the application is being closed. Now we rerun the application to verify closing our application deleted. The records are they are still there. Bingo, our records are still there. So what we did was like we created an application with based on the database. The functionality, remaining functionality is same. So what we can do is like we can also get a record by ID. So let's get this particular record, provide the ID here, and here it is foo bar 1. We can also do the same for deleted. So to delete it, what we can do is like just go so remove record by ID. We provide an ID actually. So we are going to delete the foo1 record. Now when we go there, the foo1 should not be there. Foo1 is not there. So now what we are gonna do is like we are gonna update this foo2 and make its last name is equal to bar 3 or bar 4 or something. So what we do is like we go, so we make it like something like where can we do it? Okay, here. So get records, we do it here. Okay, what is the mapping? So the mapping is update record DB. So update record DB. So we provide ID of that particular record, which is this one. Then we provide first name. What should be the first name? First name should be foo2. What should be the last name? Last name should be bar 3. And email should be same. Age should be 33. Now we update it. Let's go and get records. There it is. You see, it's the same record. The email address was changed. So, and everything is updated. We can also remove it. We check the removation part. We check the updation. We check the get records by ID and everything. And now you can see everything is working with the crude application based on the database. So we can say that we did it. And now what we are gonna do is like next time when we begin our course, next time when we do this, what we are gonna do is like we are based on this one. What we are gonna do is like next time when we do this, what we are gonna do is like we'll create the crude application. Without database, we'll take the previous application without database. And we'll create a form, an HTML form. Based on that HTML form, what we are going to do is like we will send a request. Okay, so we'll have a form which will be used to create the records. Then we'll show them in HTML. We'll have links with the records. So based on those links, we'll click one link. We can delete them with the HTML. Everything would be done with the HTML pages. So right now it is only a REST API. So we'll be creating a crude application, but based on the REST. and then later on we'll be changing that particular application with the database. Or what I can do is like we'll be I can give you the homework. So you'll take that particular application and then change that particular application using database. You have seen how database works, everything is just fine. And one more thing is like, so this repository, it has methods. So what we can do is like, okay, if you want to fetch some method, some record with the age, what you could create the mapping for this one. So what you could do is like, you can come here, you could say fetch record get by ID, no, get by age. So get by age something. Find by age and give some number, maybe, yeah, okay, we have ID. So we give it the ID, okay. So age, give it the age, find by age. So now, student DB, so the return type is a student DB. What we are gonna do is like, we are gonna return the, where we are. So, find by age, we can do the same for find by email. Email, find by email. So you could do these kinds of things and you could create your own methods and everything. What you have to do is only just, you have to define those methods in the repository. And the Spring Boot would MongoDB repository or Mongo repository would actually take care of the implementation. It will do that for us. And do this work or not? Let's go and check it again. So we close the program and then we go in there and we check it whether it is working just fine or not. So get record by ID. Now we, okay, let's change another one, create another one. So we say find by age. So let's give age, it should be 30. So let's go check, are there any, okay, there is, so 33. So there is one with the 33, there was nothing with the 30, there it is. So it does the implementation itself. All we have to do is like define a method and then it does the job. So this is why I use the MongoDB repo, because Spring Boot has already done a lot of things on it. So Spring Boot actually provides everything for us. All the repositories are defined and implementation is done out of the box. We just have to define our definitions and based on that we actually have to just utilize them. So that's why I used it, I hope. And so you could do the same with the find by the find by email, and you could define your methods. So let's say foobar, email, it's the same record. You could say I need this one, this record, we could do this. So it's another record, so we could do all of these things. And this is pretty easy using Spring Boot and MongoDB. So I hope you'll do your exercise, and when we meet next time, we'll be able to do everything that we have done using HTML. So by HTML, I mean it will actually have a view. It would not be that good, but it would be a view, so we can use that for the crude applications and all that. So until then, have a good week, and I hope you enjoy the tutorial. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. And yeah, get going, do exercise, and keep practicing, practicing, practicing. And based on that, you can get better, better, and way more better. So, bye bye, take care.